Good morning, students. The CET problems. Question number 27. Before that, this is component 24. Individual problems, you can automatically try to work out the problems. Like loss and amount of charge possible. Then the connected parallel, common potential you have to find out. Loss of this charge passed from one capacitor to other capacitor means initial capacitor, initial charge is Q1 equal to C1V1. New charge becomes equal to Q1 prime. Is equals to C1 into V common. V common, you have to find out common potential. V common is nothing but equal to total charge by total capacitance. Total charge becomes C1V1 plus C2V2 by C1 plus C2. The common potential and the new charge you find out. Difference in the charge is nothing but equal to the amount of charge transferred. Like that, you can find out the remaining problems. Already see the problems we have done. And in this case, if they are connected in parallel, they will tell plus 2 plus, minus 2 minus. If they don't tell, you have to take plus 2 plus 1. Okay, plus 2 minus plus 3 compulsory, unlike polarity is connected. So plus 2 plus your. But if the second capacitor is not charged, they won't make, no need to mention plus minus automatically. Okay, so if both are charged, then compulsory you have to mention plus 2 plus. If not charged, plus 2, same condition may have to use. Next, 20, in this problem number 27, 20 farads, there is a C1, first capacitor, is charged to potential of 5 volts, that is V1 volt. And isolated means disconnected from the battery. Then it is connected in parallel to uncharged, not charged. So Q2 is 0, V2 is also 0. 30 farad capacitor is going to be the C2. So it is not charged. Q2 is also 0 in this case. They close the switch, they are connected, the charge will travel from high potential to low potential. And in both cases, common potential. That is not concerned here. What would I guess? Question case, loss of energy. In case if they give the potential like this, you take directly loss of energy equal to half C1 C2 plus C2 to V1 minus V2 square. If they mention both are charged with the unlike polarities connected, no, this becomes equal to V1 plus V2. If not connected plus 2 plus or one uncharged, whatever condition, you have used this solution. This and two capacitors connected in parallel. This V plus 2 plus condition only we are going to take. We are taking here. C1 C2 by C1 plus C2 to V1 minus V2 square. C1 is 40 farads, C2 is 30 farads. If they give microfarads, you have to be careful. Conversion of the micro into farads can be per minus, etc. V1 is nothing but equal to 5 volts, V2 is 0, it's uncharged. Then loss of energy delta U becomes equal to final energy minus initial energy. If you take final is less than initial, no, you will get minus sign. So I have to take for the derivation purpose, initial minus final, minus 1 indicates loss in this case. Delta is nothing but equal to half into magnitude we are taking, we want to take the negative sign. 20 by 20 plus 30 into 5 minus 0 square. 5 square is 25, this is 50 into 2 is 100 denominator, this is 600, 25 into 6 is 140 joules. It's a loss of energy. I'm making a little jump in between problems you need to work out. If you don't get any problems, you ask me, I will try. 37th question, no, 36th question. A number of capacitors are connected as shown in figure. The equivalent capacitance is given by. We are given many capacitors connected parallel to each other, the different values as in the diagram. We are given. First capacitor is C. Next one is 2C. And then 3C. And so on. Up to N number term. Up to NC. What is the resultant capacitance? Find resultant. They run in parallel. When the resultant capacitance in circuits. So, get your right shaft from the circuits. Resultant capacitance in the two points. Two points means you can take this end as A, this end as A. Between A and B, all are parallel. We can take even that side or even even this side also, A and B. Does not matter. Resultant capacitance. Capacitance of parallel combination. Parallel combination. Be careful with the word. In the many students, in the derivation generally, what they do is parallel plate capacitor is different from parallel combination. Parallel plate capacitor means one capacitor type. That will be connected in series and parallel also. Parallel combination means multiple capacitor in parallel. Parallel plate capacitor means only single capacitor with two parallel plates. So several plates are taken like this. So parallel plate is capacitor different from parallel combination. You know, combination is combination of the multiple capacitors. So C parallel equal to C1 plus C2 plus and so on plus Cn. Here it is C plus 2C plus 3C plus and so on plus Cn. Yes. C you can take all common. 1 plus, 2 plus, 3 plus and so on. Summation to n. N into? N into n plus 1 by 2. Summation to n. This C into n into n plus 1 by 2. So I will take this as equal to C. Is that the C is the that value from C. Next 37. Next problem 37. Capacitors 3 microfarad, 10 microfarad, 15 microfarad are in series. They are in series and connected to the power supply of 100 volts. So, we are the 3 capacitors in series. What is common for series combination is charge. C1 is 3 microfarads, C2 is 10 microfarads, C3 is 15 microfarads. So what is same for the series combination is Q is same. Q is same. What you are asked to find out is charge on 15 microfarads. What is it? But even though they asked for all these, for all charges same. Just calculate the Q. So Q is same for all capacitors. One capacitor to find out. Equivalent capacitor to find out to C equal to Q by V. C series is equals to Q by total voltage. So equivalent capacitance we need to find out. Only two are things there at formula we have, but three means we have to make calculations. Result is C series is resultant capacitance. 1 by C series equals to 1 by C1 plus 1 by C2 plus 1 by C3, which is equals to 1 by 3 plus 1 by 10 plus 1 by 2. You don't need to use the micros, etc., because the resultant is also within the same units. So, what you get equation is this is equals to 450. Series combination 1 by C series is 1 by C1 plus 1 by C2 plus 1 by C3, which is no need to use the units here in this case of micros, because we have said also we find in that capacitor micros from microfarads. 1 by 3, 1 by 10, 1 by 15, and LCM unit can calculate this as C series. You get this equals to result is 2 units. Same units you will take as you will take it for 3 to 15 microfarads again. We set up 2 into the power of minus 6 farads is the answer. C equal to Q by V basic relation and Q we want. Q equal to C series into V, equal to capacitance into V, that is the voltage, which is 2 into 10 to the power of minus 600, which is the 200 microfarads, or 2 into 10 to the power of minus 4 coulombs is the answer. Require more marks than 39. A 10 microfarad capacitor. A 10 microfarad capacitor is charged 2, charge 2, 500 volts. And plates are connected across resistors of 10 ohms. It is connected. Resistance of 10 ohms. Find the potential resistance. Find heat produced in the resistor. Find the potential resistor. First, capacitor is charged and connected across the resistance. C and V, Q. These are resistance R. Okay, the charge will take to discharge, plus minus. Means the electrons will move in this direction or the current will move in this direction. So heat produced in the power, the resistance is I square R we have taken. Power is always equals to V into I square R, V square value discussed already. And I square R into time if you taken. Power and time is nothing but energy in this. But no need to calculate the resistance. Even though this is given, don't think that every category of the question you have to use. Sometimes, not required. In this case, this is actually not required. Whatever energy stored here, if you are able to calculate that in the capacitor, same energy appears as the heat. So energy stored in the capacitor is equal to heat at the produce the resistance. What is energy stored in the capacitor? We have the formula, three formulas. Half QV, half CV square, Q square by 2C. Any of the formula you can use depending on the data given to you. So answer. C is 10 microfarads. 10 into 10 to the power of minus 6 farads. Potential V is 500 volt. Okay, resistance is not required right now. Okay, resistance given on data we might know from this case. And energy stored. Energy of capacitor equal to heat energy in resistor. In resistor. Because you are already given C and V. Which is equal to, that is nothing but equal to, is equal to half C square V. Half into 10 microfarad, 10 into 10 to the power of minus 6 into potential difference is 500 volts, which means 500 into 500. 0 C to take 5525 by 2 into 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 10 to the power of minus 2.5 by 2. 1.25 joules is the energy. So this is no need to use this. Next question is important, even for theory also it can be asked. For last question. Last year it was asked for the concrete exams only. It is there in the textbook also. Similar problem is there in the textbook also. We have discussed that. Several identical capacitors. Several, so means many numbers are there. Several identical capacitors, all are identical. Each value is 8 microfarads. And surge voltage, means maximum voltage the capacitor can stand, is called a surge voltage, is 250 volts. That means if the cross, the voltage applied to the capacitor takes is 250 volts. The electricity is strong enough to exceed the dielectric strength of the dielectric. Then dielectric starts the conducting. Means dielectric breakdown takes place if the voltage exceeds 250 volts. So that's why it should not cross 250 volts. Same voltage is 250. Beyond that, the capacitor dielectric will damage and burn up. Next, what we have to use in these capacitors? Many of them. Capacitors to get the result time. We want 16 microfarads. And voltage source we are having is 1000 volts. We require 1000 volts. We have the 1000 volts. And we want the 16 microfarads, but we don't have 16 microfarads. What we have is 8 microfarads, many are there. But each can withstand only 250 volts. So if you keep the capacity in parallel, 8 plus 8 becomes equal to 16, easily we can get it. But 250 volts only remains. Parallel voltage will be constant, 250 volts. But 1000 volts if you apply, they both will burn out. So what you do is, connect in series. If connect in series, voltage will be divided. But capacity is also reduced. So what we do is, we take some capacitors in series. N capacitors we are taking series. taking capacitance series, the total voltage is equally divided among them because they are all identical capacitors. So total voltage divided. Total voltage is how much? 1000 volts. You have to divide among these so that you will get only 250 volts or less of it, not more than that. So 250 by 1000, 1000 by 250 to divide, you will get how many capacitors required in a series combination. So 1000 by 250, how much is? 4 you will get. 4 capacitors you will get in series. 4 capacitors you will get in series. But capacitance also reduced now. What is the capacitance becomes is C by L. In series combination, capacitance becomes equal to C by L. We call it as a C row. This is C, each row becomes equal to C by L. N is how much we are getting is 4. How do you calculate L first is? We take N by taking the voltage. Voltage available by voltage of each capacitor. Divided by you get the L value. That N capacitance you get is 4 now you are getting. N is equal to 4 you got it. So 4 series. So series C capacitance becomes how much? C by 4. C how much is 8 microfarad. That means what 8 by 4 is 2 only limits. 2 microfarad. But 2 microfarad is a very small one. Very small. How much one is? 16. That means you have to go parallel. Parallel capacitance will be added. So the each one is this is 2. 2, 2, 2, 2 like that you have taken. How many you have taken? 2, 2 is 4. If you take 2. Next 4 if you take no? 8 you will get that. So how much you get is? This is 2, 2, 4, 4, again 8, okay, that like that you check up to how much you get is 16 microfarads you get, okay, then how many rows you are taking, that is M you take, M rows, N in series, like that we are taking the M rows, total number of capacitors is M into N, so we'll take first here. N is number of capacitors in series. N is number of capacitors in series. How do you calculate this? Is V total is divided in for N values. So what you get here is N is nothing but equal to V total available by V each potential. Each value is how much? V total is 1000 volts. By each voltage is 250 volts. Okay, here this will be is equals to 4 U. So number of capacitors series is 4. And data are given C each is 8 microfarads. And voltage each is 250 volts. Is it required value? C total we want is 16 microfarads. This is required. And V total that is also available is 1000 volts is also available as required voltage. It has to work for these cases. Okay, next, so we got this is 4. So C, you will get like this again. C plus C. This each row is 0. What is 0? We got is C row is nothing but equal to C each. By here, which is equals to 2 microfarads. So we calculate here. But actually, without writing anything also directly we can calculate that on the either here itself, but you have to be careful with the source. Next is this one. N we want. Next is M rows we have taken it. Like this, we take M rows. M rows. M rows. So what is given to capacitance? Total capacitance is supposed to be equal to number of rows into C each row. So the definition is C total. In parallel combination you are taking up M parallel combinations. Parallel M rows. You will get the total capacitance C total equal to M into C row, M into C row. So we want to calculate this M. M is equals to C total by C row. C total means is the required capacitance, which is equals to C total is 16, C row is 2. Units will be cancelled, which is 8. We'll be getting is 8. So M is 8. Like this, and like this is N. So this is N. n and like this is n. So total capacitors, total number of capacitors is equals to m into n or n into n, that is 8 into 4, which is 32 number required. Okay, sometimes in calculations you may get a fraction, number division voltage is known, you may get this as a 3.5, 3 point anything. You cannot cut the capacitor, one capacitor only. So what you take is round it to higher number. If you take a 3.1, don't take 3, you have to take a 4, don't take an approximation down. Even if you take 3.00, if you get also 001 also, we have to take extend to higher numbers. Round it to higher or leave the fraction like that only. Maybe sometimes in calculation, no, that will be cancelled here. So you can check up that. Check up if it's not going to be cancelled, okay. Otherwise, here only round it to higher numbers. A voltmeter connected across a charging capacitor shows 100 volts voltmeter reading for charging capacitor. It is connected across parallel to it. For charged capacitor, for charging capacitor with air. Voltmeter reading for charging capacity A is 100 volts. 100 volts. Charging capacity A is 100 volts. That is the voltmeter reading. On introducing the current into the plates of capacitor, the voltmeter reading changes by 26%. On introducing dielectric between the plates of capacitor. Of capacitor. The voltmeter reading changes by 36%. Find out the constant material. Find dielectric constant of the material. Find the dielectric constant of the material. Here potential changing. If the battery is still connected, potential will not change. If the battery is still connected to the capacitor, always remember that point. Sometimes they will mention battery is disconnected like that. Remaining like that. But here we are introducing the electric after removing it from the battery. How do we know is that there is a potential changing? If battery is still there, what is the voltage of the battery? Same voltage will remain from the capacitors. First it is connected to the battery and then disconnected it. Now we are connecting the voltmeter process, ideal voltmeter. Think of the ideal voltmeter resistance is infinity. So it doesn't, charge will not flow. So we are connecting across this first with the air and connecting across the voltmeter. This voltmeter reading is 100 volts. Then you are introducing the electric within the plates. It is not partially filled, completely filled, even whatever. This voltmeter reading, this electric as V1, this voltmeter reading is V2. Reading is different. Introducing the electric between the pent plates and capacitor, always capacitance increases, but potential difference decreases. Potential difference, electric field decreases, force also decreases, electric field decreases, everything decreases except capacitance. Capacitance increases by k times, battery is there amount. If battery is there, voltage won't change, potential difference always remains same as long as the battery is present, electric field are supposed to. So in case if you take the inside the electric may change if you introduce it, but the potential difference battery is disconnected, no. Once battery is connected, V medium equal to V air by k, electric field also becomes equal to by k, decreases by k. So here in this case, battery is not removed, and electric is introduced completely filled. Now potential difference decreases by k times. So So the new reading is V2. What is V2 becomes V is V1 by K. V2 by K decreases by K times. Okay. First with A, this is A1. With the directivity of constant K. With the directivity. So K. But what is required is K we are also to find out. You are not given V2. What is given is percentage changes here. You have to be careful. Reading changes by, not changes to. Changes to means final value, changes by means difference percentage. Percentage always takes the changing values by initial values of percentage. So percentage change in the product difference. Percentage change. Relative change means into 100 which is not right. Percentage change means into 100 value. Right? Changing value by initial value. Initial value is related to A value. This is nothing but equal to delta V by V A into 100 percentage. Which is the relation. This is nothing but equal to V A minus V A by V A into 100 percentage. This is with median. This is with the A, V A, V median. Okay, so what is V A is 100. V median is 100 by K. Okay, by V A. And calculate the value of K from this relationship. And percentage is what? Right, the percentage is already given. How much is given is 36% is given. This value is given. This is nothing but equal to 36%. Percentage changes, changing values by initial value to 100. So you need to go directly from this. Changing value, initial value is high, so initial minus final. The final value is more in KD derivatives, you know, percentage change the final minus initial value. Okay, so large minus small value. So in this case, V air is more than V medium. So difference by V air into 100. You can take this as 1 minus V medium by V air. You can take convert like this, or we have the relation model from the medium here is V medium. V is equals to V A by K. So V2 is with medium. V2, okay, this is V2 or V medium we can take is equals to V A. This is nothing but equal to V A by K relationship. V2 is V1 by K. Put the value here and you get the V medium by V A. V medium is equals to V A by K. So 1 by K you get. So this right side limit is 36 by 100. 36 by 100 is 0.36. Take 0.36 take to the left side. This ratio of the potential is to the right side. This minus becomes plus, 0.36 becomes equal to minus. The result is 1 minus 0.36 is equals to V medium by V air, that is 1 by K you get. And 1 by K is 0.6, we want K, directly constant. K is equals to 1 by 0.6, 100 by 64 is equals to 1 by 6. No ends and dimensions for the directly constant. The potential difference, next problem for number 44. The potential difference with the plates of the capacitor increases by. This increases by. Y means again a change value. By 0.1%. And find the percentage change in the energy of the capacitor. Find percentage change in the energy of the capacitor. Okay. Here, small percentage if they are given, rotate the bigger formulas. Small percentage, rotate the U2 minus U1 by. U1 into 100% is not required. When they are taking the percentage is less than 1, 0.1, 0.2, 0.4 or less than that, so we don't take the approximate formula we have to use. That error formula we use. What is the energy of the capacitor? Is energy of capacitor. You are given C related and V voltage change is given. So V formula we require to take the percentage change in the voltage because potential difference changing here. V comes to a delta. Energy formula we have to Q, V, etc. No. Here what remains constant is the battery voltage changes, the charge also changes. But capacitance do not change. Capacitance depends on the designing of the capacitor. What is the formula for capacitance? Epsilon naught A by D into K. So for the given capacitor, A constant, D constant, directly not changing what? Capacitance C is also constant. C does not depend. Capacitance of the capacitor do not depend on the battery or the charges. Charge depends on the voltage. More voltage, more charge. Now, but in this case, one, we have to take the constant terms, we have to take more. So, charge term formula don't take. Constant is C, variable is V. Half C means when you can take. So, energy of the capacity is U equal to half C this one. Small percentage changes we have taken. Percentage in U equal to percentage in C into percentage into V. But V square is always 2 comes as the multiplication. But C is a constant here. Constants variable don't take. Here C is constant. So, C is constant. And number 2 is also constant. That is not a variable. Variables only we consider for the changes here. So delta U, percentage in U, percentage change in energy is delta U by U initial value into 100% which is equals to, here what we take is nothing but equal to 2 power is there, that comes as multiplication, differential form. So 2 into delta V by V percentage into 100% and then directly I'm writing here as a percentage. Into 100, into 100 here also. Not just type in the percentage. So percentage is energy is nothing but equal to power what happens then now into 2 times delta V by V. What is given for you? Percentage is the V already given. Point 1. Increase or decrease, carefully done. Increase what is there means plus. Decrease means minus. So delta V plus plus 0.1 M. Percentage change in voltage is equal to plus 0.1%, that is increase. Therefore, percentage in the energy becomes equal to is equals to from this relationship 2 into 0.1%. Plus means plus. So 0.2%. Plus only coming, therefore you get is increase. In any expressions, if you get the terms denominator, take a denominator becomes equal to power minus comes. Okay, power comes minus. For example, D. By mistake, the plate with the plate, capacitor plate slightly changes. Then give the percentage in the D. D taken to limit becomes d to the power of minus 1. And d to the power of minus 1, if you are taken, whatever minus is there now, comes as a multiplication here. Minus 1 into. Minus is there means you get the minus in.